If you need to import video footage from a tape-based camera, you'll be using a process called capturing, and that's what we're going to look at in this video. If this doesn't apply to you, for example, if your camera records to its own hard drive or removable media card, and you're sure that you'll never need to import from a tape, then you can skip this video and go straight to the tutorial on ingesting video files. If you do have a tape camera, the first thing you'll need to do is connect the camera to the computer using a FireWire cable. Once you've done that, we can open Premiere Pro and get started. Let's first have a look in the menu under Edit, Preferences, Capture. And this gives you just a few options for capturing video from tape. The default settings should be fine, but it's probably just good to know where those preferences are. We'll just cancel that, and what we're really after is the capture window, which you can find under File, Capture, or the keyboard shortcut F5. In this panel we have a preview window here, which is blank at the moment. You have a status display at the top, some tape transport and record controls at the bottom, and a bunch of settings on the right hand side. So first of all, let's just have a look at some of those settings. If we click the settings tab, first of all we can see the capture settings, and at the moment it says HDV. If we click the edit button, we'll see we can capture in HDV format or standard DV, and in this case we're going to be capturing in HDV. Underneath that we have the capture locations pane. In most cases you probably do want to leave it on the default, so we're capturing the video to the same location as the project, and the same goes for the audio. Underneath that we've got the device control. Again, we're going to be capturing a DV or HDV device control. It uses the same sort of system. But if you want, you can click the options button, and that gives you a few more options in here. You can select the video standard, and you can select the device that you're after. Hopefully it's just recognized your camera as it is, but you can select the brand of camera and the exact device in here, and a few other options there. So at this stage, we're just going to cancel that and carry on. There's also just a couple more options here, for example the pre-roll time, and you can choose to abort the capture if it drops some frames along the way. In most cases you probably don't want to have that checked. If we go back to the logging tab, there's just more options here about where we can log the clips to. We can enter the name of the tape in here, the clip name, description, etc., some notes about the clips that we're capturing. We can choose to enter some time code settings in here so that it will only capture certain parts of the tape. We can capture from the endpoint to the outpoint, or you could click the tape button to capture the entire tape in one go. Underneath that we've got the scene detect option. Now I do recommend that you have this on. What that does is it means that you can capture everything from your tape, and Premiere Pro will attempt to split up everything that you've captured into individual clips, and it does a very good job of that. So I'm going to turn that on and you'll see how that works shortly. So if we go back to the main part of the window here at the moment, at the top in the status display you'll see that it says stopped. That's a good sign. It means that Premiere Pro has seen my camera and recognized that it's currently in stop mode, which is why we don't see anything in here. Also down the bottom, all of these controls are active. If Premiere Pro had some trouble seeing my camera, or it wasn't connected properly, these would all be grayed out. And at the top here, instead of seeing stopped, I would see something like device is offline. It might also say that the device has been detected, but the controls are still grayed out. That would mean that Premiere Pro has seen the device and it can capture, but it can't control the camera. What we really want is to be able to control the camera down here. If you can't control the camera down here, that's not so bad. You just have to press play on the camera and you should still be able to record okay. So let's have a try, shall we? We'll just press the play button and we'll see what happens. Okay, so that seems to be working. What's happening here is you're seeing exactly what's on the camera. If I look at my camera viewfinder, which is sitting next to me at the moment, I can actually see exactly the same thing on my camera. So I can control the whole thing from here within Premiere Pro. So let's just rewind the camera back to the start and we'll try and capture the whole thing. This time what I'm going to do is I'm just going to press play here and then record. Okay, so I'm doing this manually. I don't really want to capture the entire tape at the moment because I've only got a few minutes worth of footage. So I'm just going to press play and record. You'll notice in this case that the picture goes blank. You can still hear the video going underneath, but I can't see it. That's because it's recording in HDV and it just blanks the window out. For DV files, you will actually be able to see it here while it's recording. Now you'll see that it's creating new clips as it goes. That means that the scene detect is working correctly. It's splitting up the incoming footage into individual files. So we'll just let it capture a little bit more and then I'll come back. Okay, that's enough. I've captured everything that I want to, so I'll just press the stop button. You'll see our status has gone to paused. I'll actually stop it. And I'm just going to close that window now. Have a look back in my project panel and you'll see that all of these clips have come up in here as separate clips, which is fantastic. I'll just open one of them and have a look. And let's see, I'll just play this one here to show you what we've got. And you'll see that that's actually a very short nothing clip. I don't really want that. So I can just go back to the project panel, hit the delete key, and it's gone. Now if you'll remember from the last video, these items here in the project panel are actually just references to the real files on your computer. So when I delete something from the project panel, it hasn't actually deleted it from the computer. If I really want to delete it forever, I could go into my computer or Finder on the Mac and physically delete the file. Or to make that easier, I could just right click on the file, select Make Offline, select Media Files Are Deleted, and click OK, and that will physically delete the file. I don't actually want to do that to that file, so I'll just leave it as it is. Now you'll notice that I did muck one thing up really in the capture window. Because I didn't give this clip a proper name, I left it as Untitled Clip. Premiere Pro has named all of these clips Untitled Clip with a number sequence, so that's not really ideal. It doesn't really matter, especially for a simple project, but really you'd want to be a bit tidier than that. If you had done this in real life and you didn't want to recapture everything again, perhaps the easiest thing to do would be to go to Adobe Bridge and do a batch rename. We'll worry about that some other time, but for now, that shows you how the capture window works, and we'll come back in the next video and have a look at how to import files from your hard drive, which is something that you'll need to do. Even if you have a tape-based camera, you'll still want to do that to import other types of files, such as still images, maybe extra audio files, and that sort of thing. So thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video.